flag, bitch.
Good morning, guys. So today we're going to continue with the install of the turbo kit. I'm definitely going to try to get done the power steering today. I couldn't drain everything with the turkey thing, so I'm just gonna put something down there and remove the hoses and let it leak. After that, I'm going to remove this hose. I already drained my coolant. I just have the coolant on the reservoir, but other than that, I don't have any coolant left. So I'm also going to remove the reservoir so I have more space. And then I would have access to remove the belt and then the power steering. Then I'm going to relocate my reservoir, power steering reservoir over here. I have to see how I do this one. I'm pretty sure that this is for the aftermarket alarm that I have. Probably gonna put one of them here and the other one here, but I'll figure out how that's gonna work once I have the reservoir here. And then I have to get under the car to see how I set up all the lines. Obviously the cooler is gonna go on this side with the bracket, so yeah, let's see how that goes. Yesterday I removed the windshield fluid reservoir, but I'm gonna put that back, maybe not today but at some point, because I know for sure in the 350c you can keep it. And then I might remove it in the future, just because I've seen that that's the space that people use to put an oil cooler, and I'm definitely gonna need one, so I'm gonna use that space for the oil cooler in the future. But for now, I'm just gonna have the reservoir back there. And then the horns, like I was saying at the beginning of, at the end of the last video, the instructions show like the G37 only has like one horn, and it's connected somewhere else, and it's just like the side looks different. So I'm not sure if these horns are gonna be interfering with the intercooler, but if they do, I'll just completely remove them, because the thing is, the harness is attached to this thing, and I'm pretty sure that this is what tells you like if your hood is open or not. I don't wanna touch that. I prefer to have my horns because I don't use them anyway. Also, for the power steering, there's a sensor down here, this one, that I don't think we're gonna use it with the new power steering, so I think I just have to zip tie that to the harness. Update, guys. I took the reservoir off and it's already here. I think this is where it's supposed to be. I had this here. I think this is for the aftermarket alarm. So I move it a little bit to this side, and probably gonna zip tie that there. And yeah, the reservoir is here. So I think that's where it's supposed to be. I still have to remove the lines. But yeah, all the cooler, so remove the cooler as well. Have to see how I can put the bracket here. As you can see, I have it there, the cooler is here, so I'll figure that out later. For now, I'm going to start removing the hard lines, and then I'll probably move down to remove the ones from the bottom, and then remove the belt to start working on removing the power steering pump. Good morning, guys. Quick little update on the C. As you can see, the intercooler is on. Honestly, that's one of the last steps, but I wanted to do it just because I want some motivation to keep going with this, because it's honestly taking out all my patience. And I finished all my power steering. Pretty much everything with the power steering is done. That's the new power steering with the new lines. You can see the relocation here, it goes to a reservoir, and then that one goes to the cooler, and then the one in the passenger rack is this one, and then the other one goes to the cooler. So all those lines are already set up. What else? I put the belt back on. Like, I had to take all this, I had to remove the fan. Yeah, I had to do a lot of stuff. So here's the reservoir, it's pretty secure. But yeah, the only bad thing that's been holding me up is this heat shield. This nut right there. I don't know if you're gonna be able to see it, but screw. I round it and it's just rusted in there, so I haven't been able to take that off. So I'm just gonna see if I can literally cut the heat shield and just take it off, and I need to remove it anyways for the install, and then after that I'll continue to remove the other two heat shields and then continue to wrap in the lines. But like I said, depends on how long it takes me to remove the heat shield on how much I'm gonna be able to get done today. Hey guys, so this is where I left off for today. I'm really tired, so I have a cut here. Yeah, I have my hands full of cuts from removing all this stuff. So I was gonna do the lines for the battery that goes to the starter and the alternator, but I took a shower and I'm really tired. I really don't feel like working on the car right now. I removed the fuel regulator and the EVAP line to wrap them up later. Probably gonna do that tomorrow. Same as these lines. For now, the power steering pump, as you can see, is all done. The only thing I need to do is buy a sealant for one of the lines that is connected to the steering rack. I don't know if I showed this before, but the intercooler is finally on. As you can see, here are the lines from the power steering. That's the cooler. So hope you can send me the right bracket. This bracket is pointing the other way, and yeah, I finesse, but yeah, I don't like how it's touching the intercooler, but it'll make do. Just in case you guys are doing this for UC, you have to like cut that bolt there, because if not, it's not, the intercooler is not gonna be able to fit, and then you also have to remove like a piece of metal that this sensor is in, and then this metal, you just move it to this side. And then the horns I just left in there, they're barely touching the intercooler, so I think that should be fine. So just in case you're installing a top mount turbo kit for your TVTC, that's basically what you have to do, because they don't really say it on instructions for the 350C, but they do have a picture that they're explaining something else, but I just noticed that and I tried to replicate the same thing and it looks like it worked. So hopefully I don't have to take off the intercooler. I mostly did it just of the look and to have some motivation to keep going with this build, because it's kind of driving me crazy, but at least we already have the space for the turbo here. Oh, I forgot to mention, I was finally able to remove the heat shield from here and also the one from below. So yes, thank God, I don't have to deal with that anymore. The only thing is that the bolt is still there, but I don't think that matters, because obviously nothing's gonna fit in there. And I think it's mostly about this area right here. So we should be fine in terms to that. Tomorrow, I'm probably just gonna wrap the lines and maybe try to do the motor mounts. That way I can start doing the exhaust later on during the week, probably
Thursday or Wednesday. Other than that, I think that's it. Follow for the next parts of the build. Hopefully we can boost this car between a week or 2 weeks. I still have to get my injectors and my fuel pump, but I mean, as long as the kit is installed, I can put those things on later. Also, I need to get my gauges, but I'm getting the gauges and the injectors from the same guy. So I should be getting both of those things at the same time, and the fuel pump doesn't have to do anything with like the whole engine bay, so I can just do it whenever I'm ready to tune the car, and that's it. Thank you for watching, guys. Hopefully you guys are learning something from these videos, and I don't know, follow me along the journey. I'm just documenting this because it's the first time that I do something this big for this car, so hopefully everything goes as planned, because it's definitely been a roller coaster of emotions for this build.